Cranes provide a fast, energy-efficient, and an environment-friendly mode of transit. Trains run on rails. While a casual look at a railway track would indicate that track laying would be fairly straightforward, put on the sleepers, bolt in the steel rails, and trains are good to go. However, a lot more goes into laying of railway tracks. In a cross-section, a railroad, at its very basic, will comprise of a subgrade, bottom ballast, sleepers, rails, and top ballast. The subgrade is prepared by removing all obstacles and compacting it. Water is the biggest enemy of a railroad. Any stagnant water can weaken the railway structures and compromise its load-bearing capacity. To prevent water stagnating below the railroad, the subgrade is provided with an incline, which is usually recommended at 1 in 40. This ensures that water will not stagnate and will drain off. After the subgrade has been prepared, a bed of ballast, called the bottom ballast, is laid. The ballast is made up of rough-edged stones because the sharp edges of the stones make it difficult for them to slide over each other in the way that smooth pedals would, thus effectively locking them in place. The sleepers, or ties, are then laid over the bottom ballast. In the pre-mechanization days, this process was done manually. Most railways today use automated track laying machines. These machines can lay as much as a mile of track in a single day. After the sleepers and the rails are laid, the top ballast is added. The ballast serves as a load-bearing structure. It holds the tracks in place as trains pass over and facilitates drainage of water. A tamping machine compacts the ballast into a tight fit with the tracks and the sleepers. It also checks track geometry and maintains the correct alignment of both rails.